Joining me tonight, political commentator, best-selling author, syndicated columnist, historic and legendary icon. Good to have you with us. It is, you know, and it's absolutely true. You have been fighting the left in this country for quite a long time now and with immeasurable success. Obviously, President Trump helped a bit in 2016.
Yes, he did.
Could you have possibly imagined that the president would have achieved what he has in terms of the economy, markets, and rolling back regulation, setting a whole new tone for this country?
What I didn't realize was how real the swamp is. I mean, he
That's
is really being opposed by all of official Washington, D.C., which is why it's unfortunate that so many of his appointees are part of the swamp, because they're fighting him. And the media, I hated before. Wow, do I hate them now. Until they are utterly discredited.
By the way, look into the camera, because watching you right now are tons of Americans who see it exactly that way. The left-wing media is driving the support of this president, I think, in large measure.
Oh, I totally agree.
He is standing up, despite, as you say, being attacked, assailed every day from every quarter.
Viciously with lies.
I'm sorry?
Viciously with lies, lies, lies. I mean, he's absolutely right on the fake news. I mean, the funny thing, I'm obviously a little testy with him because we don't have our wall yet. But then the media attacks him and they bring me back to defending him.
Right.
You know, I'm like a sitting duck. You could get me to attack him. I'm mad that we don't have a wall. But no, every day it's some outrageously unfair attack and they bring me back in.
Well, you have to be. And by the way, I want the wall. I want the wall now. I wanted it actually 6 months ago. Though that may not be realistic, but having the wall next year is definitely realistic. And secondly, you have to credit the Trump administration for having the lowest immigration rate, crossover rate of that
right.
border in recent memory.
Right. I mean, what concerns me about that is, I mean, this is why I supported him. I think that he's still living off the rhetoric of the campaign.
Mm-hmm.
And that was an important campaign.
Oh, but that's not fair. I mean, we're
They're
talking about substantial, concrete, highly specific achievements. And I just enumerated just some of them.
But the fact that fewer illegal immigrants are trying to cross in, that is a result of his rhetoric. It is not because we have a wall. Mm. He is allowing ICE to do their job,
mm-hmm.
but all of the things that we like that's happening, mm-hmm. it goes away like that with the next president. Only a wall is forever. That's what people were chanting.
Did I just hear you hold him not only accountable for his campaign promises to the American people, but for the next three or four presidents, say, as well?
Oh, for the next millennium.
Yeah. Well, I think he's making a pretty good run at it because he has reversed a course under, you may remember, Barack Obama. We were looking into the abyss
with
that man's leadership.
No, I think that's part of the reason for the hysteria from the left, from the media, from the deep state, from the swamp.
Yeah.
They were just about to tip the country. They almost had it.
That's
just
why do you
four
think
more
that they
years
are,
of illegal yeah. immigrants and legal immigrants, and the entire country would be the state of California. They could taste it. They were so close. Republicans would be gone, gone, gone. So we really need yeah. Trump. I mean, if he wants to...
I'm glad to hear you moving at least in this direction, because...
What direction?
The direction of recognizing that there is no possibility whatsoever that we could have survived a Hillary Clinton.
But the same is true if Trump doesn't keep his promises.
And that we would not have been able to defeat Hillary Clinton.
With anyone but Trump. That's absolutely true. No, I have no regret for...
By the way, did you notice
but he's got to fulfill his promises.
Growing about four.
You know... Okay, I want to talk to you about that. You better stop bragging about that because the stock market is going to crash and it's not going to be his fault.
The stock market is going to what? It's going to do what? You think
it's going to go down? I'm on Fox Business where it's all happy talk. What goes up never coming down.
Well, I don't think you can say that's true of the Fox Business Network at all. I think
really?
I think that's an atrocity against truth. But the reality is that I would have to be apprised of what it means to see a market drop 5-6%. Just kidding. Ann Coulter, consider me sufficiently warned and as well entertained by your most recent visit, which is this one. Thank you. Look forward to seeing you soon.
Thank you.
Thanks.